and remind you, the truce may be vital, but without love, it is unbearable.
Hi, I'm Krista Smith and the host of The Corner Booth, and I have Jonathan Pryce with me here, which is very exciting. It's great to see you. Thank you so much for coming.
My pleasure.
This is just such a beautiful story. Pope Benedict, which is Hopkins, so much of the movie is you two together, you know, so many great scenes. Tell me what it was like to work with him.
It was a bit like Francis going to meet Benedict. He was in awe of the Pope. And I think going into those scenes with Tony initially, I was in awe of him, and I'm still in awe of him.
Pure and simple, you implied the rest of us not living simply enough.
Can one ever live simply enough?
On married priests.
I was misquoted. I said celibacy can be a blessing, it can also be a curse.
Yeah? Non-homosexuality?
All I said was...
No doubt misquoted again.
Taken out of context.
Ah.
I love him deeply. We had the most wonderful time working together. We made each other laugh a lot. He's in awe of me, and he because on the call sheet, I don't know if people know this, when you have a call sheet to go on the film set, you've all got numbers attached
right.
to you. And I was number one and he was number two. it was a cause of a lot of ribbing between
yeah.
the two of us.
Of course, who's number one on the call sheet, right?
Well, he would change the sign on my trailer. We put number two there.
Oh, he would?
He would be number one. And when he emails me, he says, hello, number one, this is sir, number two. He doesn't let me forget.
I wanted to experience the moment with you.
If I was Pope, I'd be in here every day.
Ah, what else?
What?
Well, if you had been chosen, what would you do?
Oh, Holy Father.
No, this place would be different, I think. Yeah?
So talk to me a little bit about getting this project and becoming Jorge.
That's a good title.
Yeah.
Becoming Jorge. I suppose it all started for me when Pope Francis was created Pope. The internet was alive with photographs of the two of us together, people pointing out the likeness. I wasn't very flattered. That's not what I see when I look in the mirror. But you know, even my son texted me to said, Daddy, you the Pope. And then this script came with Fernando Morales attached to it. You know, I was at first a little doubtful about playing the Pope. It's kind of a big deal, and it's a great responsibility. But it was because it was Fernando was directing, I thought I desperately want to work with him. It's thanks to him, really, that my, you know, my interest in the project grew.
What was the hardest part in getting into him?
There was nothing hard about it. I knew there were elements of him that I liked and admired. What he was trying to do, changing the Catholic Church and making changes within the Vatican was fine, but I didn't think it affected me because I'm not religious at all. But what does affect me and the rest of the world is how he's an inspiration for people to think of opening borders, not building walls, but building bridges. And I liked that aspect of him and thought this will be a worthy, good, honest project to be involved with.
Fernando Morales, as you said, like City of God, amazing. Did he live up, I imagine, to every expectation you had?
Absolutely. I mean, he and Cesar Cialioni, the cameraman, the confidence you get from working with a cameraman like Cesar is that you know that everything you do, he's going to capture. He's right in the middle of it. Certainly, and it was all his work was handheld. And then you've got static cameras around the set. But you always knew that Cesar was there supporting you with the camera. And then Fernando is just a fantastic man. He's very warm. He's also very intelligent, and he also knows exactly what he wants. He just guides you into the way of doing it, and then he sits back, and we all sat back and enjoyed the experience.
You learn so much in the movie, just about humanity and tolerance and pushing.
I mean, that's the great thing about it is you know the title could put people off thinking I'm going to say a treatise about the Catholic Church, but what you're going to see is two men discussing issues of the day, discussing humanity in a very, I'm surprised how much people laugh. and that's a great device. It's like theater. You make people laugh and then you undercut them with the seriousness of what you're talking about. And I think that's the beauty of this film. It's very entertaining.
We're at an impasse. You cannot retire from the church unless I agree to your going, and I cannot resign until you agree to stay. It's a conundrum, a theological conundrum.
You don't understand. It could never
be. We know in our heart of hearts that it could be.
Your body of work is beyond, and just the theater. I love that you're going back to the theater. Do you prefer one, or do you like to mix it up all the time? Because you do.
When I can make a film like The Two Popes, I would always say I prefer film.
The attention to detail is just magnificent.
Yeah, yeah.
I loved every minute of it. But
thank you.
Thank you very much for coming in to talk to me.